Hello, it's Misa here. I'm back again to show you all the coloring books that I got for this month. I told myself to try to not buy as many books as I did the last few months, but somehow I ended up getting 26 books. So I think I have a problem. I'll start showing you the books. I got two books from Robert Roscombe. I've never really heard of him before until I saw these books. Actually, I saw this book first on Amazon, Raspberry Hill. I thought it was very cute and whimsy and had little cute mice. And you all know how much I love little mice and stuff. Actually, that's not a mice, that's more like a hamster maybe? These are the mice. But it has really cute images. The paper is on I think Create Space paper, so it's really thin. I then looked at his other books and I saw this book. The cover's not very appealing, but the images inside are really, really, really whimsy, and it kind of reminds me of the Nice Little Town books, except it's not towns. Actually, some of them are towns at the front. This book is actually a combination of four of his books. I believe Whimsical World, Whimsical World 2, Whimsical World Forest, and Whimsical Garden. Features all four of his books, which I thought was really neat. It kind of just reminds me of the Nice Little Towns, and I love Nice Little Towns. The cover doesn't do this book justice, but it's beautiful. And then I picked up one more Lacey Sunshine book, the Spring Romantic one. I have to admit that I wasn't that into the images in this book. There are some nice images, like this one's quite pretty, but overall I didn't really like this book as much as her other books. Then I got this corgi coloring book. I love corgis, and I've been trying to get a corgi for a very long time. But there just isn't any here in Australia. Well, there is, but it's really hard to find. So I've been looking for corgi coloring books, and I saw this one. It's very simple. It's kind of more aimed for kids, but that's okay. This book is actually split into two. The first half is colored by numbers, and then the other half is more color however you want. So yeah, it's just cute little corgi pictures. Paper is also Create Space paper. And then I got cute dogs. This is a bit more realistic looking dogs. I think the images here are very nice. I'm not sure how I'll colour them because I don't know how to colour fur yet, and since this is so realistic and non-cartoon like, I'm kind of scared to colour in it. Not yet anyway. Then I got actually I got three books from Molly Harrison. So I ended up looking at her books again, and they are gorgeous. I don't know what's wrong with me. I don't know why I didn't like her books, but they're really, really beautiful. The fairies are beautiful. I really like her work. But I noticed most of her books are grayscale books, and I don't like grayscale, so she doesn't have that many coloring books. And after a while, that will kind of seem the same. So that's Magical Fairies. And then I also got Colorful Fantasy. But I might pick up her other books, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure if she only draws fairies. I've seen one mermaid book from her, but I don't know. Her mermaids didn't look that nice. Like the tails, there's something wrong with the tails to me. But I kind of hope that she releases some mermaid books, because I prefer mermaids over fairies. Oh, this one's so pretty. It's Molly Harrison books. And then I got Carousel Dreams from Yen Puff. I've actually been looking at her books for a while. But I don't know. I find her girls a bit odd looking. Then again, they're kind of cute. But I picked up this one because I love the more unicorn-y, well, pony unicorn kind of images. But yeah, she has two other books. Actually, let me skip my stack here. I actually got another book from Yen Puff. This is her newest book, The Chibi Zodiac. I saw this on Etsy, and I was really hoping she'll release it as a book. And a few days later, she actually did, so I'm very excited for this. she's got two versions. She's got like her usual style, and then she'll have the chibi for each zodiac. Very pretty. I have to admit that I was a bit disappointed with my particular zodiac sign, the image for it, but oh yeah, she also added the 13th zodiac, officious or something. I didn't even know there was a 13th one, but yeah, she added 13-1. Very cute book. Then I got The Red Mansion. This is the fourth book from this series. This is actually a very popular series of current books on YouTube for some reason. Well, not for some reason, for obvious reasons. The images are gorgeous, as always. So these are the images. Again, I don't think this will be a favorite from this series. I kind of prefer her older ones. Some very pretty pictures. And then I got Chibi Pets from Nathaniel Wick. I've seen some of his other books, like the mermaid one and the fairies one, but I'm not too into his style. But this book was really, really cute because I love the big eyes on the animals. So I had to pick this one up. Yeah, this book is really thick. See, it's really thick. And it has a lot of images. A lot of variety of animals too. So adorable. And the rabbits. Since the paper is kind of like the Jade Summer kind of paper. It's kind of different from those other Create Space paper, but I don't really know what paper it is, but adorable book. And then I got Nice Little Town 5 by Tanya Bugima, who I thought was called Tatiana. Or maybe she is called Tatiana, but So this is like a continuation of her Nice Little Town 4 with all the mice and the mice house. And again, you know how much I love the mice. So I had to pick this one up. I kind of like her Nice Little Town 4 a bit better. I don't know why, but I love this one too. Spire. But I think I prefer the book 4. Adorable, still. And then I got 2 Sherry Boldy books. Sherry Boldy, she kind of reminds me of Heather Valentine books, but I kind of... there's something about her girls though that bother me. Like, some of them will look quite nice, but some other ones look a bit like, what was she thinking? I don't know. They just... But anyways, I decided to pick up Steampunk Sweethearts as my first Sherry Boldy book. I'm not sure why, but steampunk doesn't usually appeal to me, but for some reason this one kind of did, which is weird because I don't... Sherry Boldy, I don't have any Sherry Boldy, but anyways, I ended up deciding to go with this one as my first Sherry Boldy book. The images are nice, but I don't know, something about the faces and their heads, I don't know. Something about them. And then I got her older book, Enchanted Moon and Stars. I love moons and stars, so this was one of the books that I was kind of thinking about getting, but then not wanting to get it. Like, you have pictures like this, which is quite nice. Quite nice. And then there's like these ones. But what is that with these pictures? Then, yeah, these ones are pretty. Yeah, I don't like this one either. But, yeah, it kind of reminds me of my favourite Heather Valentine book. But, I don't know. Like, this one, something's weird with this one too. But, yeah. That's that book. Then I randomly picked up this one. LOL Surprise Pets. It's actually for kids, I know, but I love pets and I really wanted like a little pet shop coloring book, but for some reason there isn't any on the market, so I went with this one because I know LOL Surprise is very popular with the kids these days, but yeah, I haven't really seen what they look like, so I got this book. Again, the big eyes, but I found the pets a bit, I don't know, they're a bit similar looking, but I think it'd be good for days where I just want to relax and color something big like this. Yeah, but the images are really simple. That one's cute. Yeah, that's that. And then I got 2 Jade Summer books. I finally decided to get this one. I've been flipping back and forth with this Live Your Dreams, but I wanted more inspiration books in my collection, so I decided to just get this one because I actually like it, but at the same time, I wasn't sure. But yeah, because I don't know, because it's the patterns, they're really basic looking and just patterns. nothing amazing. But yeah. And then I got the mermaid one. I bought this as soon as I saw it come out. If you were, I think, part of the Facebook group or part of subscription, her subscription list. Jade Summer actually sent out a free PDF to everyone, so yeah. But I wanted the physical copy, so I ended up buying it anyway. I love the art style in this. I much prefer the style of this over all those other ones that Jade Summer has released previously. But yeah, I'm really happy with the releases they're making, like, in the last few months. They're right up my alley. And then I got 4 books from Julia Rivers. First one I got was Serene Little Village. Oh yeah, don't mind my voice. I have a bit of a cold, so Serene Little Village. This one's got, again, lots of cute animals in their village. It's a little bit more intricate, but it's still so cute. I especially love the ones that are indoors. So cute. I was actually not sure if I wanted to buy this one because it was a bit too intricate for me. Well, it's not that intricate, but a bit too detailed. Like, look at these leaves. But yeah, I'm very happy that I got it. It's adorable. Oh, I love this picture. This was the image that made me want this book. That's Serene Little Village. Then I got 3 of her, 3 of their simpler books. I think these ones are not aimed at children. But so this one's Enchanting Fairies. Oops. I mean, they're quite cute, but I don't really like their faces. Which is the same for all 3 books. So it's the fairies, enchanting princesses, ponies, and unicorns. Again, I don't really like the faces, but I really like the unicorns and the ponies that they have in this. Yeah, so they have some where like they're together, and some where it's just the princesses, which I don't like. And then they have the ones that are the ponies and unicorns by themselves, which are the ones that I really like. Yeah, adorable. And I got Enchanting Mermaids. This one was a must get for me, even though the faces are a bit weird, but because I love mermaids, I kind of have to get all the mermaids book that I find. Oh, cute. Speaking about mermaids, I think I already got the Jade Summer Mermaid book, this mermaid book, and the rest of the books here are all mermaids. I got another book from Deborah Muller. This one is apparently a colouring journal, so like apparently this side is more for journaling, but to me this book is just like a single-sided page, coloring page with a more decorative back side to it. I see it like that more than a journal. But this one, I really like this one. This one's my favorite out of the Maya Deborah Muller books. Yeah. Not too much. Another Deborah Muller book, Mermaid Tales from the Tiki Bar. I love this picture. Her art style is very unique, but I don't see myself being crazy ever collecting her books. But I do like her mermaids. And then I got another Deborah Muller book. This is Miss Fantastic. It's an inspirational quote book. This book is actually the reason why I went on a little Deborah Muller splurge. Yeah. I love mermaids. I love inspirational quotes. What could be wrong with this book? And the last book I got, Saving the Best for Last, is Pop Manga Mermaids. I love this book. I love, 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 love this book. I've had this book on pre-order for the longest time, and I thought I had to wait till July, but I got it early June this month, and I was quite surprised. Actually, I might have got it at the end of May, but anyways, I got this super early. I'm not sure why, but I'm absolutely in love with this book. It is so adorable. Again, her style is really unique. She has like some more sketchy looking pictures, and then she has like these double page spreads, which are the ones that I really, 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 really like. So there's that one. Now these ones are quite nice too. Yeah, these double page spreads, they are so, so, so cute. Yeah. I'm not a big fan of the sketchy ones, but these ones, absolutely gorgeous. I'm actually a bit afraid to colour in this book because I'm scared I'll ruin it. So I'm gonna practice in all my other books, and I don't know, it might take years for me to finally touch this book, but absolutely gorgeous. One of my favourite books ever. So yeah, if you love anime kind of books, if you love mermaids, definitely, if you haven't already, go out and get this book. It's breathtakingly beautiful. So that's all 26 books that I got this month. Oh, so heavy. So here's all the books again. That was a lot of books. Okay, thank you again for watching my video. I'll have flip throughs of all of these books on my channel. So yeah, if you like this book, please give me a thumbs up, and I'll be really happy if you subscribe to my channel and stay subscribed. It's so sad when you see the numbers go up, but then yeah, a few minutes later it goes back down. But yeah, that's just me. You don't have to subscribe, it's okay. But yeah, hope you like watching this video, and I'll see you again next month. Bye.